Yeah. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Amityville High School for the championship game of the Fred Williams Memorial Tournament, featuring the Knox School and our own Warriors from Amityville. Let's meet the starting lineups of both teams. First, for visiting Knox, number 23, KJ Anderson. Number 24, Reggie Pierre. Number 1, Fabian Wheatley. Number 10, Angel Yepes. Number 12, Fletchy Beachy. And now, here are your number 0, coming up with a 16-point game last night, Matthew Bean. Number 10, the men on the glass, Wes Blake. Coming off a 22-point game last night, number 24, Amir Dickerson. Number 32, Dejan Ming Clinton. And number 1, senior guard, Seville the Thrill Williams. Amityville is coached by Jack Agostino, assisted by Anthony Agostino, AJ Rice, and Billy Kress. Today's officials, referee Joe Hickman and James Howard. And as the old saying goes, let the players play, the coaches coach, the referees officiate, and you guys please cheer loud, cheer proud. Play ball.
Oh! Thank you. Yes. Defense!
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your patience. Thank you again for attending a great tournament each four volley programs. The co-MVPs from Amityville are Amir Dickerson and Seville William. And the MVP of the Fred Lloyd Memorial Tournament from Knox School with 24 points tonight, Fabian Wheatley. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending this great annual event. Get home safely and happy holidays.
there since I was 6, since I was 14 years old. And I know you can never shoot.
Good job. Well, good. Thank you. Happy holidays. By the way, you're mad at me.
Thank you.
that Alex?
Thank you. One of the yellow ones goes in the custodial class right here. Is your pizza?
told the kids 10, we're closing at 10.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
so I swear, wow, school closing at 10. Because they won't leave. Once I get them here, they won't leave.
Yeah, no, no, no.
I think we're going to be okay. He keeps telling me that.
Listen, in the limelight of a Y-Nance rivalry, we respond.
Yeah.
A little bit of a, again, anticlimactic, like a lull today, because, you know, when you had a big win.
I understand that.
For a young team, they're not going to be able to take a game by game situation. You know, they got up the last night, and it's a mental letdown to them. 64-60, I know.
The streak. You were saying
we missed possession. We missed four layups and three layups, one jump shot, and we gave up three layups and one three.
What was the offensive rebound too? It was the kid 24. That's what Christian. We don't miss a scoring. We miss a rebound.
Yeah.
The kid was a great fucking rebound.
But we're farther along than I think. We're farther along than we were supposed to be. I'm just saying.
I think we'd be good too. Obviously, with a new team. And I thought Monday's the key because it's league games. League games are additional. It's like a scrimmage. And again, they've had
to
get
back to reality.
And that's similar to a team not as good, but the type of play we're going to see, those traps. Good jump shooters. Like, we'll see that, and we'll have size here.
What is the best guard we'll see all year? So I meant 24, 23. Where? Who has that on Long Island?
Where are some of those kids from? I was most curious.
Well, 24 is from West Lysa. Great kid.
They live there?
Lives in West Lysa. 23 is from Wood Melville, my neighborhood. And Fabian, I think he's from, I don't know where he is. I know he's at St. Thomas.
Do they live there?
Oh, the other? No. They came here. Yeah. So the kid over there, and I just said number, the kid who hit all the threes against the left, he lives in West Battle. He was on West Battle. I don't think he was on that JV, but I know I remember seeing him.
Better this or last year. He doesn't look like a player, but all of a sudden he comes.
No. Look like a player. Number 10?
No, number 11 in the dress.
Yeah,
he's an awkward body.
The kid went two big threes.
No,
it wasn't him. It was the other kid.
Oh, 11?
Yeah.